laid out there like a small scale research project, and of course, but this is a peer reviewed journal, so had high confidence in this. The work was actually carried out mostly on Long Island, New York, so it's looking like a pretty good piece of scientific detective. Just published about a week ago, April, now, so recently published in September. Now, initial messenger RNA, mRNA vaccines and clinical trials excluded several vulnerable groups, according to this paper. Young children and lactating individuals, which we would call breastfeeding women, in England, at least most of us would, were excluded from the trial. Now, safety and efficacy of the BNT COVID-19 vaccine. Now, this was the original vaccine paper that we responded by the original Pfizer. We did it in great detail at the time. So, based on this original clinical trial, at least for this particular vaccine, we find that they randomly assigned persons 16 years of old and 16 years of age and older. So, you had to be 16 to get in the trial. So, that was the requirement for the trial. Now, current recommendation from the FDA, based on that and presumably other work as well. Today, this is the announcement from the FDA. Today, the Food and Drug Administration authorized emergency use of Moderna COVID vaccine, but Moderna and the Pfizer vaccine for the prevention of COVID-19 to include use in children down to 6 months of age. So the original research was based on to be 16 and over, now down to 6 months of age. That was as cited, and obviously was being careful to cite the original site, so that is the particular vaccine paper there, and this is the FDA site, so being careful to cite official data, of course. You might have your opinions on how justified the difference is, but we're just citing the official papers. Back to the JAMA paper. Now, this is from the JAMA paper. The US Food and Drug Administration deferred the decision to authorize COVID-19 vaccines for infants younger than 6 until more data was available because of the potential priming of child's. Priming of the child's immune response that may alter their immunity. So, a bit difficult to work out what they're saying here. They seem to be saying that giving a vaccine under the age of 6 months could potentially prime the child's immune response with unpredictable consequences, is what they're saying. Of course, the child that's 7 months old is only 1 month older than a child that's 6 months old. Being careful to cite official data. COVID-19 vaccine while breastfeeding. This is the Centers for Disease Control and Prevention. Now, I've been using the US sites here. The UK advice is working differently, but it's essentially the same. There's no real scientific applied clinical difference between the advice and the two patients. So, breastfeeding. Mothers, direct quote, COVID vaccine is recommended for all people 6 months and older. This includes people who are pregnant, breastfeeding, trying to get pregnant now, but might become pregnant in the future. So it sounds pretty inclusive. So certainly the breastfeeding thing is included. Breastfeeding can be vaccinated. So back to the JAMA study again. The Centers for Disease Control and Prevention recommends offering the COVID mRNA vaccines to breastfeeding individuals. Okay, terminology for now. But it's clearly saying, so this is a direct quote from the JAMA paper, quoting the giving evidence from the CDC. Although the possible passage of vaccine mRNA